Well, g'day guys. The water's starting to cool down a little bit, and our focus is sort of shifting from the snapper and kingies to gurnet, terakee and blue cod. So I'd just like to show you A, how we tie our terakee rigs, and B, how we tie our gurnet rigs.
Alright guys, so we've got some 50 pound trace here. And first thing what we want to do is create a loop to attach our swivel on, which will come off our rod. So you've seen this one before, double over, make a granny knot, and you just want to do that four or five times. Traditionally it's six times, but depending on the thickness of your line, you might be able to get away with one or two less. Just like that, pull that up tight, give the tag end a little tweak, and that's given us a beautiful knot and a beautiful loop that we will clip our swivel to. Trim our tag end off. If I find my knife, here's my knife, just like that, and there's our loop. Now we're going to move down the line a little bit and create our first dropper. We want this gap here to be at least 30-40 centimeters. So we're going to tie a twisty dropper here. Now what you do is make your loop and you twist this up. There's no set amount of turns, just keep twisting till it's nice and tight around your finger, just like that. And this is the part we're going to attach our hook to. So once we've done our twists, we tie just our standard dropper loop. So pinch this part in our mouth. So just coming back to the dropper rig guys, I'll give you a little rundown with this cord. Now it's really simple. Put however long you want into your mouth, double over your line, and then you're going to twist them around each other. One, two, three, four. Go five. Then the loop you've got in your mouth, this one I haven't twisted, but this would be your twisty part on the previous part of this video, just goes back through that hole. Really simple. Put it back in your mouth and pull her up tight. And that is how you do the dropper loop. And pull it up tight. Just like that. Now what that's done is it's created a beautiful twisted up dropper. Now that just for me looks nice. It's a nice presentation and it just keeps everything together and sticks it out from the backbone of your trace and makes it look all pretty. So you've got our twisty dropper here, and this is the part that we're going to attach our hook to. I like to put a bead on. Generally we're fishing 60 to 80 meters, so a little bit of lumo down there definitely doesn't hurt. Push our bead on, and we've got these really cool little BKK hooks. These glow in the dark. These are the BKK glows, and they're really they're dynamite. They're great. So I reckon they make a difference as well. And traditionally, like any circle hook, you go through the top, just like that, push it back through the loop, pull it up tight. Then you can slide your bead down, and what I like to do here is just push my soft bead up over the eye a little bit, and that just gives us a really nice presented hook really. Little bit of squid on that and you can't miss. So here's one I've done earlier guys, our little loop on our trace. We're going to hit our swivel onto there, coming down our trace to our first hook, first dropper loop, just like that, to another one, and then down just to our normal loop with our sinker. And we can change our sinker weight as we need to. And that is our standard terakee rig. Alright, so the gurnet rig, pretty simple guys. We've got our little loop that we've already done, which you know how to tie. Strip off a little bit of line. And we're just going to tie that loop again. Now I like to use a nice long dropper. Sort of that sort of length.
and we're going to tie our six over granny knot. One, two, like I say, doesn't have to be six, but it depends on you, on your line thickness. What's that, four, five, and we're going to pull that up nice and tight, and that's created our dropper loop, which our hook will go on. So on these rigs, I like to put the hook on at this point. So we pinch the end, and again, a little glow bead. I do believe Gernard like a little bit of bling, not too much, but a little bit. And we've got our BKK circle glows. This one's a 5-bar-0 through the top. Thread your hook on, slide your bead down, again just like to push it up over the top, which makes our hook hang out nice and easy. And then where I'm going to tie my trace for my my loop for my sinker, what I like to do is I like to measure where my hook's going to sit on the bottom part, and I pinch basically the same length as my dropper is where I want my sinker. So pinch where I want it, and then just tie our normal loop. So basically it's the same rig I use for everything. Trim that tag end up. So basically it's the same loop, or the same rig I use for everything, but my distance between my sinker and my hook is shorter. That way, when your sinker's sitting on the bottom, your hook is very, very close to the bottom. As we all know, the gurnard hug the bottom, so it's a good idea to have your bait on the bottom. If your dropper loop's too high up your rig, then the gurnard sometimes won't swim up and grab it. So that's just a little trick I like to do. I have my sinker just a little bit longer, or the same length as my dropper. And there you go. Now you can either attach a normal sinker to this end, or you can put one of our little Shimano slow jigs on there, the little bottom ships. These things are dynamite, and I just tie them on as a sinker, don't bait them, and as these are bouncing up and down on the bottom, it's quite often you'll catch a fish on one of these as well. So that's a little tip there. Anyway, that's all from me, guys. Take care out there, and we'll see you next time.